In this video, we are going to learn how to protect an application with the Microsoft MS Build integration for Visual Studio. This integration is a simple NuGet package that must be installed in the project or application that we want to protect. This package automatically integrates the obfuscation part in the compilation process. This allows us, for example, if our application has an automatic deploy, it is a Xamarin application that has to be packaged in an APK. It is going to be deployed to GitHub, Amazon, Azure, or any hosting service. We can automatically apply the obfuscation at the time it is compiled and not have to deal with it after the application has been created. This way, we can automate the process. Let's get to it. Here, we have a very simple example application. If we execute it, we will see that it shows us a series of texts. This will be the application that we are going to protect with ByteHide Shield. To do this, we must install a package. This can be done from Manage Application Packages or from Tools, NuGet Package Manager, and Manage NuGet Packages for Solution. It should be noted that if we want to protect two applications within the same solution, we must install the package in both applications. To manage it globally, we must do it from Tools, NuGet Package Manager, and Manage NuGet Packages for Solution. We will look for ByteHide Shield, and this is the package we have to install. It is important to check that we are always using the latest version since we make updates in the package to implement improvements and new features, so it is advisable to make sure we are using the latest version. Here, we can choose in which projects or applications we want to install it. In this case, I will only select testing app. We give to install and we give to OK. The package would be installed correctly. What do we have to do now? It is simple. We close this window and we enter in the project of the application making double click. In case it does not open automatically, we will have to go to the folder and open the CSE proj file. Here we can see that we already have the package added, and now we must link our ByteHide account to protect the application. All these configurations are going to be done on a new property group. We open the property group and all the configurations will be here. What are these configurations? The first thing is to link the account inside the MS Build documentation of ByteHide. We will have all the available configurations. Let's first add the ByteHide key, create a new property with this name, and close it. To link the account, we need to get the API key from our ByteHide account. Inside the ByteHide panel, we go to User Settings, API Tokens, and create a new API token with the name we want. It is important to have checked the Shield service. Click on Create and here we will have our API token. We copy the API token and paste it inside ByteHide API key. We have already linked our Visual Studio project or application with the Shield obfuscation service of ByteHide. Now, only one more configuration is missing, which is which preset or which protections this application should be protected. To do this, we go back to the documentation and add Shield preset. Inside protection presets, we will be able to see the four that exist. Maximum protection will protect the application to the maximum. Balance will protect looking for the balance between security and performance, protecting everything in an advanced way. And optimization will protect only the most critical and vulnerable methods and will leave aside the interfaces, visual resources, and others. On the other hand, there is the custom preset, which is used to apply the protections that we want manually. For this example, we will use the balance preset, paste it inside Shield preset, and save. At this moment, we have everything ready to protect our application when compiling it. It is necessary to emphasize that if we do not add any more configuration, the protection will be applied only in release mode. Besides, if we have installed the Shield extension as it is my case, it is necessary to disable it because it would be protected first with the Microsoft MS Build integration and then with the Shield extension. This would cause the application to stop working correctly. To disable it, we will go to Build and make sure to leave the ByteHide Shield enable option unchecked. If we now recompile the application, we can see that the Shield obfuscation process is added to the compilation process. It will protect the application with the protections included in the balance preset, and it will tell us that the application has been successfully protected. This is the simplest way to protect the application with Microsoft MS Build integration, but more advanced options are available. If we go back to the MS Byte API documentation, we can see that we have the force option. What does force mean? It means that with this option, we don't have to protect only in release mode. If now I compile the application in debug mode, we can see that it is not protected. But if we add Shield Force, true, we will be able to force the application to be protected in any mode. Another option is Shield Enabled. That allows us, for example, let's imagine that we don't want to protect our application for a while because we are testing. We don't need to uninstall the package. We simply mark the Shield Enabled option as false and it would no longer be protected when compiling. How can we use our own custom protections for it? First, we eliminate Shield Enable to protect when compiling, and instead of using the preset balance, we will use the press custom. By using custom, we will be able to select the protections we want. To do this, we will add Shield protections, and inside we will have to put the ID of the protections we want to use. For example, we are going to use the renamer protection, copy the ID of the protection, and paste it inside Shield protections. If we save the file and recompile the application, we will be able to see that it is being protected even if we are in debug mode because we have set Shield Force true, and we will see that the process log is shorter because we have only applied the renamer protection. If we wanted to use more than one protection, we would simply have to divide the IDs with semicolon. If we now go to the web panel, inside Shield, in the project section, we will see that a new project has been created with the same name as in Visual Studio. This project is simply a link from our cloud panel to Visual Studio or to our application, but we have the option to load the protection history, and we can check that we have protected first with balance, then with custom, with the renamer protection, and finally with several protections together. This way, we can keep a history of our protected applications.